If you want to study abroad, then there are two destinations which are very, very popular: United Kingdom and Canada. So this video is a comparison between UK and Canada from the perspective of international studies. So in this video, we'll compare the two countries based on their quality of education. We'll compare them based on the education cost and the cost of living as well, because that's also very important. We'll also compare the immigration prospects, the work permit, and getting the PR after completing your studies. And then we'll compare the weather, the job prospects, and apart from that, we'll also compare the different intakes in these two countries, and also a few important factors like working during studies. So this video is going to be an ultimate comparison between UK and Canada for international students. If you're interested, stay tuned. Okay guys, before I proceed with this video, I quickly want to give a reference of a detailed video of UK versus Canada that I created a few months ago. This is specifically for all of those people who want to immigrate on a greater picture, maybe on a work permit or maybe want to get the PR. So this is for all of those people. If you are interested in knowing all of that, you can also check out this video. Okay, so to start this video, let's start the comparison with the quality of education in the two countries. Of course, the two countries actually offer great quality of education. There's absolutely no doubt about that. But because we are here to compare the two, we will make this comparison based on the number of universities in the top 200. So the rankings for 2021 and 22 from Times are out, and they say that UK has got 28 universities in the top 200 around the world, while Canada has got 7. And just to give you an idea about the quality of education, let me tell you that none of the Indian universities or colleges are in the top 200. The top most educational institution from India, Indian Institute of Science, has got a rank between 300 and 350. So you can understand the quality of education in these countries. So to talk about the universities in UK, first of all, we have University of Oxford at number one position. Then University of Cambridge, number 5, Imperial College London, UCL, London School of Economics and Political Science, University of Edinburgh, King's College London, University of Manchester, University of Warwick, University of Glasgow, and the University of Bristol at 92nd position. So of course, there are many other in the list of top 200, but this is the list of those which are in the top 100. If you talk about Canada, then we have University of Toronto at 18, University of British Columbia, McGill University, McMaster University, and University of Montreal with 88th rank. These are in the top 100. And then University of Alberta and University of Ottawa in top 200 as well. But apart from that, of course, there are many other universities like University of Manitoba, University of Victoria, University of Waterloo, many others which are not there in the top 200 but hold good rankings in the list of Times. So needless to say, both the countries provide world-class education. But yes, if you compare between Canada and UK, then UK might win that race. Okay, a lot of people are actually worried about the expenses. How much would it actually cost you to study abroad? So if we talk of these two countries, UK and Canada, then we can definitely say that it's not cheaper to study in any of these countries. And it's also difficult to give you an idea of how much would actually cost you, because the education cost might differ from one college to the other. And also in the same college, depending on one course to the other, the education cost might differ a lot. But in generic, if I want to give you an idea, then an undergraduate course would cost you somewhere around 10,000 to 19,000 per year. And a postgraduate course would cost you somewhere from 12,000 to 25,000 USD per year. Now, if you talk about Canada, then tuition fees vary significantly across universities. And you might see that the lower end is actually a lot cheaper than what it is there in UK, and the higher end is even more expensive than what you'll see generally in UK. So this range actually increases even more when we talk of Canada. And if you're going for an undergraduate course, then it would cost you somewhere from 7,500 to 22,000 per year. And in the case of a postgraduate course, it would cost you somewhere from 11,000 to 26,000 USD per year. Here it's very important to note that these costs that I've mentioned here are in USD, because UK is in pound and Canada is in Canadian dollars. So I've mentioned a generic currency here in USD. So if you want to convert in your home currency, in your local currency, you can actually convert it from USD to that. Okay, now talking about the cost of living. Of course, it's not just the education cost, but living in these countries is even more expensive. So in the video that I created earlier, I have a detailed explanation of cost of living, how much would it actually cost you to live in one particular city of UK versus Canada. But if I talk in general, then living in UK would actually cost you somewhere from 12,000 to 15,000 USD, while living in Canada is a bit cheaper because it will actually cost you somewhere from 7,500 to 9,000 USD per year. Now here it's very important to note that this is just a generic range, and of course the living styles, the living standards might differ from one person to the other. This is just a rough estimate of what is the cost of living for students in these two countries. Alright, now let's talk about the different intakes in the two countries. So first of all, talking about UK, we have the term 1 which starts in September, then we have term 2 starting in January, and then term 3 starting in the month of April or May. And there isn't much difference in the case of Canada as well, because here we have different names but the times are same. The fall intake is in September, the winter intake is in January, and then the summer or the spring intake is in the month of May. So this isn't actually a difference but a similarity between the two countries, and just like that we have one more similarity when we talk about the number of hours of working that is allowed during your studies. So an international student can actually work for 20 hours a week if you talk of UK, and similarly in the case of Canada as well, you can work for 20 hours a week during your studies. Most of the people who study abroad want to work and settle there as well. So let's check out what are the immigration prospects after you complete your studies. So in the case of UK, after you complete your studies, you actually get a graduate visa for 2 years. And in the case of those who complete their PhD, they actually get 3-year graduate visa. This visa is a restriction-free visa and you can work for any company. I actually made a detailed video about this graduate visa. I'll provide the link in the description box below, so if you're interested, you can check that out. Now, you cannot extend your graduate visa. However, you may be able to switch to a different visa. For example, a skilled worker visa. And then you can continue working for any organization. Once you've completed 5 years of working in UK, then you actually become eligible to apply for the permanent residency. But this journey from study visa to the permanent residency is definitely not easy. And you might face a lot of hurdles in between. But hurdles are everywhere, even in the case of Canada as well. So after you complete your studies, you actually get a postgraduate work permit in Canada. If you complete a 1-year course, then you get 1-year work permit. If you complete 2 years course, then you get a 3-year work permit. And similar to graduate visas, this postgraduate work permit of Canada is not extendable. This is a one-time opportunity, and after your PGWP expires, you can apply for a work permit to work in Canada. And then once you gain the Canadian experience, you get 1 year experience of working in Canada, then you get more points and you can apply for the CEC category of the Express Entry System to go for the permanent residency. Apart from that as well, there are plenty of options if you complete your studies from Canada, because there are some provincial nominee programs as well which can help you get the Canadian PR. And you definitely have a greater edge if you've completed your studies in Canada and at the same time you have 1 year Canadian experience as well. Now the Express Entry System is a point-based system, and you get a certain number of points based on which you get an invitation from the Canadian government and you can apply for the permanent residency. Similarly, the Skilled Worker Visa of UK is a point-based system as well. I made a video on Skilled Worker Visa as well. I'll provide the link in the description box below, you can check that out. And I've been making regular videos on the permanent residency of Canada. If you're unaware and you want to know about that, then you can check out dozens of videos on my channel to know about that. So all in all, the pathway to permanent residency is a lot easier in terms of Canada. And eventually, after becoming the permanent residents, you can actually apply for the Canadian citizenship down the line as well.
Whenever Canada is in discussion, then talking about the weather becomes very important. So here I've listed out the maximum and the minimum temperatures of 3 cities of UK and 3 cities of Canada. The minimum temperatures are in the months of January and February, and the maximum temperatures are in the month of June and July. So we can clearly see that the weather of Canadian cities are much more colder in the months of January and February, while these cities get slightly warmer than the UK cities in the months of June and July. So we can certainly say that the Canadian weather is much more harsh, especially in the months of winters. And one thing that I've personally noticed is that living in UK, you'll experience a lot of wind, that you won't get to feel too much here in Canada.
Okay, now let's talk about the job prospects. Will it be actually possible for you to find jobs easily in these countries? So first of all, let's check out the unemployment rate that is there in these two countries. So after pandemic, of course, the unemployment rate in all the countries around the world is high, but in the last few months both the countries have gained back a lot of new jobs, and the unemployment rate in UK is 5.6%, while in Canada it is 6.9%. So in that way you can think that UK is slightly better. And also the average salary in UK is 42,900 USD, while in Canada it's 42,400, which is still quite similar. Now this is just the average salary, guys. Of course it depends on you, if you can get a better job, if you can crack a job that can pay you more. Now of course in just one video it's not possible to discuss about various types of jobs, so I'm just going to list out few of the important cities which actually provide most of the jobs in these two countries. So if we talk about UK, then there's London, Manchester, Edinburgh, Bristol, Leeds, Birmingham, Oxford, Cambridge. There are many other cities like that. And then when we talk about Canada, then there's Toronto, Vancouver, Montreal, Ottawa, Calgary, Halifax, Edmonton, all of these cities. These all cities that I've mentioned here have got plenty of jobs in the technology sector, in IT, in marketing, sales. Alright guys, so that's it for this video. I really hope that you would have liked the content. If you did, please click the thumbs up button. Please put a comment in the comment section below if you have any queries. I'll definitely try my best to answer those queries. And obviously, please do not forget to click the subscribe button if you haven't done that yet. Thanks again for watching this video.